Hello, my fellow YouTubers and subscribers, and welcome to my latest movie review, where today I review Transformers 1. Yes, Transformers 1. So this movie is essentially a reboot of the Transformers franchise. As we know, the Transformers movies began in the live-action form in 2007 with Michael Bay, and then he made 5 movies, which were, well, fairly unpopular. And then this franchise continued with Bumblebee, which was not directed by Michael Bay, and then Rise of the Beasts, which was the last live-action Transformers movie. I think there were 1 or 2 animated ones. Whatever, way back then. So this one is directed by Josh Cooley, and the story is as follows. The untold origin story of Optimus Prime and Megatron, better known as sworn enemies, but who once were friends, bonded like brothers, who changed the fate of Cybertron forever. So, Transformers 1. Now, I have to come out of this and say I was surprised at how good this movie was. Okay, this movie is not a masterpiece. It's not amazing. It's not the holy grail of the Transformers movies. However, it is definitely a step in the right direction, and I believe it is what the Michael Bay movies should have been. Granted, I do have a slight soft spot for the first 3 Michael Bay movies. I did kind of enjoy them as a guilty pleasure sort of thing, but they were definitely aimed at the wrong target audience. And then the next 2 came out. Not a fan. So the series was kind of in a state of limbo after that, and the next 2 were better, so the series was going in a different direction. Even though it was still live action, it was getting better. But this one is definitely more kid-friendly. It's definitely less leery than the Michael Bay movies. He definitely had some sexual humor, which was totally inappropriate for those movies. But the action of Bay's movies was kind of enjoyable to varying degrees. But this movie has definitely played more for the right demographic, because I've always said Transformers is something that young boys would enjoy. You know, robots hit each other. There's not really much more to it than that. So there really isn't much to the story in terms of it being more than a fun action movie. But it is interesting to see how Optimus Prime and Megatron were friends and how their rivalry really began because of Sentinel Prime. I will say this, though. I think Sentinel Prime is kind of a weak antagonist in this movie. He doesn't seem to do very much. He's kind of wasted, and his motivations seem to be very much power driven. I don't think there's anything more than that, which is a real shame, and I think that they could have really expanded his role in a lot of ways. He's basically there as a plot device to set up the breaking of the friendship of Optimus Prime and Megatron. I mean, they have different names in the film. I mean, I think Optimus is called Orion Pax at one point, and Megatron is called something else, but I can't exactly remember. I think the direction is very solid for this, and I think that the action is done well, and it's not overbearing like Michael Bay's movies were. I think the problem with Bay's movies was that he tried to make them too epic, and it really became gratuitous. Very tiring, very exhausting to watch, to the point where as the films got on, they got longer. So it sort of felt like you couldn't really just enjoy them for fun. This you can enjoy for fun, and it's not even 2 hours long. It's the shortest one yet, and I think it benefits from that runtime. It's 1 hour 45 minutes, which is perfect. The humor is much more kid-friendly this time. The jokes don't always land, but it's more appropriate than what we've had previously. The CGI is great, and this movie fulfilled my biggest wish for the Transformers franchise. It's all set on Cybertron. For years, I've been saying it's time to ditch the human characters and set the whole damn thing on Cybertron. And finally, they've done it. They've actually thought, you know what, we need to set this entire movie on Cybertron. And it is basically an origin story. You could argue that you could potentially see this as a prequel to the Michael Bay movies. I mean, the logo is very similar, so I don't know if it's you could intend it that way, but I think the intention is for it to be a reboot. I think Transformers 2 will follow in this kind of same style, and it won't be quite so adult as Michael Bay's movies were. The voice cast are pretty good. You have Chris Hemsworth doing an American accent for Orion Pax or Optimus Prime. I mean, he's not Peter Cullen from the Bay movies, but he still does a good job. Sometimes he over-enunciates the accent, but I think it works, and I think he definitely brings the right emotion to the character, and I think, honestly, he does a good job. Brian Tyree Henry as D-16. Oh, that's it. Yeah, D-16, otherwise known as Megatron, is very good, and you just begin to see over the film how his hatred really consumes him of the betrayal of Sentinel and what that means for him, and how he just can't kind of let go of that, which is interesting. And I think that it's a much more character-driven Transformers movie than the previous ones, because with the Bay movies, you kind of don't feel like they're actually about the Transformers in some ways. You just feel like they're kind of about the human characters, whereas this one, it puts the Transformers as the protagonists and the antagonists, and they go on journeys. And granted, it's a very simple, basic meat and potatoes kind of story. It's very straightforward, but it does the job. And I think all the kinks are ironed out. And I think, the cogs are put into place and they mesh together in the right way. Scarlett Johansson, or Johansson, whatever, as Elita. She's good. I think she's cool. I think it'd be nice to see her do a bit more in the future, but I think she did a very good job. Keegan-Michael Key as B-127, I'm guessing is Bumblebee. I kind of liked Bumblebee more in the Bay movies with the fact that he had this voice modulation radio that he couldn't actually talk without the voice modulation. But the performance is still good. Steve Buscemi as Starscream. Brief, but very good. Lawrence Fishburne as Alpha Trion. Very, very good. I mean, you know when Lawrence Fishburne is in a movie, his voice is very distinctive, to say the least. And John Hamm plays Sentinel Prime, who, well, is a little bit wasted in the movie, but is still pretty, pretty good. And the visuals are great. I mean, the CG is very, very good, and I like the way they've designed Cybertron's world, and I would actually love to see more Transformers movies here. If they continue the series, I don't think they need to go to Earth anymore. I think it's better to just stay here on this world. And this is the exact point I am making about the Sonic movies. Granted, I get that people love the Sonic movies, and to each their own. I've never been a fan of the Sonic movies because they could be set on Sonic's world. Why bring in human characters? And I think the first two Sonic films have made that mistake of focusing too much on those human characters, taking away from Sonic, which is what Bay did with Transformers, because the humans became the center. And it was like, well, no, I mean, okay, fine. For the first movie, it kind of makes sense, the whole kind of E.T. thing with Sam Witwicky discovering Bumblebee. But the rest of the movies could have been set on Cybertron. Honestly, they could have done. So I'm glad that they're finally making up for this now. And I do honestly think that, yeah, Sonic going forward could follow this formula. Is this movie a masterpiece? No. It definitely has clunky humor, but not as clunky as Bay's humor. It's a fairly well-paced film. There's a couple of draggy moments, but it doesn't move too slowly, all things considered. Some of the writing is very bare-bone. It's very basic, so perhaps they could have been slightly more expansive. I would have liked to have known a bit more about Cybertron. We get a very brief exposition, so I think maybe the exposition could have been slightly stronger to explain everything. But nonetheless, it's a pretty good template for what's yet to come. So all in all, I think Transformers 1 is a very solid movie. It's very entertaining. The third act is actually very good, and I think that's the best part of the movie. It builds up to that third act, where it gets surprisingly dramatic for what this film is. So overall, I think I'm going to score Transformers 1. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. It's definitely one of the better Transformers movies. Is it the best? Maybe. It's kind of up there. It's definitely in the top three, because I do really like Bumblebee. That one is probably my favorite at the moment, but we'll have to see. I might revisit the Transformers films at some point, but I actually think I enjoyed this one more than Rise of the Beasts, which is saying quite a lot. So that's my review of Transformers 1. What do you think? Please comment down below. Let me know. Please hit the like and subscribe button. And until next time, I'm Pejax Perspective. See ya. Bye for now.